Well, many of you have asked me to make a video of how I edit my images, so I'm going to try and pack this into 10 minutes, how I would edit this photo of the Faroe Islands on the island of Kalsoy. So let's get started. So I tend to start a little bit underexposed for my images, so I'll go a little bit darker than you would go normally, and I'll increase my contrast to start with. So I'm just basically working my way down here in Lightroom, starting from the top and going all the way down. And then what I'll do is decrease my highlights pretty much all the way and increase my shadows to create sort of a flat look for my image. So this is a bit of a going forwards and backwards. I'll come back up to the top and I'll keep adjusting until I'm happy with the end result. But there's sort of a process that I'll go through most of my images. And then once I'm happy with an edit, I'll have a preset that I'll create and then apply to most of those images of that job, of that collection, or that style, so I have a consistent look throughout the whole job, country, or whatever shoot I'm doing. The whites and the blacks really affect the saturation of my image, so I have to be really careful about these. We're going to create a bit of an oversaturated image now, then we will create a flat image out of that, and then bring back individual saturation / reduced saturation in different areas. So this is my starting point, somewhere around here. I'll probably come back later. Then clarity I would never touch. I highly recommend not using clarity on your images. It just increases the contrast in between pixels, but it's not looking at the real contrast in the whole image, and it just ruins the look and feel of an image and makes it incredibly busy. If you know my photography, I like to have a slightly reduced saturation in my images. So instead of reducing the whole image, I'm just going to slightly reduce it here by going to minus 10%. And then later on in further down, we will edit individual colors to get the look and feel I want. So this was quite a stormy and crazy day, so we will try and replicate that feeling of that day. The next thing most people don't really touch, or don't touch enough, I think, is the tonal curve. And there are two ways of editing this curve. By clicking on this little square down here, you can change the way you're modifying the curve. So we have the tonal curve, and if I click on here, we go to the RGB curve. The RGB curve basically changes the brightness and the value, the hue of the primary colors, so of red, green, and blues. Let's create a little bit of an S curve for the RGB curve in general. And I tend to bring up, you would know this as probably as a fade effect. So I'll bring up my black values a little bit. And this is really comes down to a lot of tweaking. And I'll bring them up to almost 20%. So you can see the percentage up in the top of the square here. And I'll create a couple of points here just to bring it down a little bit in the not so black areas. And don't worry, it looks a bit crazy right now, but we will get to a point where it all makes a little more sense later on. So we're going to flatten this out a little. And I tend to bring up or bring down my whites as well a little bit. Just down like 5%, something like that. So we've created a really flat image right now. As you can see in the histogram up here, there's a lot of blacks that have gone basically taken out and a slight little bit of the white area, which means we won't have any clipping on both sides. Perfect. Now, the next thing is to go into the individual colors. I might speed this up a little bit. This is really tweaking. I'm going to show you on the reds, and I'll be doing very similar things on the greens and the blues. I basically create a little of an S curve, which increases the contrast in the color contrast. So I'll reduce it down here, and I'll increase it up here. All right, there we are. I've gone through and edited my curves for individual colors, and I've adjusted this curve a little bit as well. And we've got some contrast back in here. Now, for my taste, that's way too colorful. And instead of just changing the saturation, I will come down into the individual colors down in the HSL panel, which is a hue, saturation, luminescence. Here I can edit individual colors. So we'll come down and start with saturation. I'll start moving the primary colors, which is in this image, the blues and the greens, and I'll reduce those quite a substantial amount. So I'm happy with the saturation now in general with this image. The next thing to do is to bring those colors into a color spectrum that I quite like for this. So slightly cool and slightly a little less green. It's a little too green for my taste right now. So I'll start bringing those greens towards the yellows a little. And what I'll do with the yellows, which you think there's not that many yellow colors in here, but we will start modifying them, and you can see how especially in the foreground and the bottom, we're getting a little bit of a different color going there. So that's good. And hopefully we can change the reds of the lighthouse to bring those to punch out a little more as well. And then the blues, the ocean, and the distance, we can probably cool those down a little bit by pushing those a little more towards the purple end. Now the next thing, I'm pretty happy with the color spectrum. Now the next thing is to change the brightness of each color. So instead of changing the brightness of the whole image, we will start to change the brightness of each individual colors, and we can really selectively push the eye towards our subject or towards a certain area in the image. So I'll start increasing the yellows and the greens and see what happens. Okay, overall, color, from the color palette, I'm pretty happy. I think I'll go back up to the top and add a little more white to just punch that out a little extra. And maybe reduce the blacks a little further just to increase that contrast a little more. Okay, it's starting to look good at the top. Let's bring it down here a little. I think the greens are pushing a little too much and it's almost becoming too distracting. So we'll reduce it here. So as you can see, it's a bit of a back and forth to get it right. And it's really a creative choice. Okay, once I'm happy with the general brightness and saturation of my image, and I want to sort of push it towards a general direction, I'll start adding a bit of split toning, a really subtle split toning, just to create a bit of a mood. So this is looking a little warm for me. So in the shadows, I'll add a little blue. I'll start doing that by adding the saturation, putting that up to about 20%, and then moving left and right until I find a color that fits in for me. Now it's a bit over the top right now, so I'll reduce it down to about between 5 and 10% somewhere, and it's a very subtle change, but it definitely adds to the mood of the image in the final image. And then for sharpening, I usually recommend, if it's for the screen, about between 70 and 80%, and then I'll mask it between 30 and 40%. So I'm happy with that. All of this I don't worry too much about. And then I'll move down, and maybe, depending on the image, I'll add a little bit of post-crop vignetting just to pull the viewer's eye more into the image. So I'll go about minus 5%. Just for the final punch, I'll give it 10% dehaze, so it'll just add a little more contrast in general. So it's looking good. It's quite a dark image, and I think we can come back up to the right to the top and tweak the tonal curve a little bit. So we'll push this, and we can actually tweak the highlights, shadows, and dark points here as well, and just see what we can flatten out a little bit of that contrast and just get rid of that color by reducing the highlights and the lights and increasing or reducing the blacks, so the darks. And that just flattens it out a little bit extra. Makes it quite just nicer to look at. And that's about it. I'm pretty happy with this right now. I'd probably do a few minor more adjustments, spend a little extra time on this. And then once I've reached a point that I really like the image, I'll usually leave it where it is and create a preset. And those presets I'll apply across my whole range of images, for example, for the Faroe Islands, and I'll use that as a base to edit other images of. That just gives me the unifying look for all the images of that job, so it really puts them nicely together in a group. What I also do, so to save myself the time and help you out with editing, I create preset packs, and those you can download. They're really cheap. And they come in about 10 to 15 presets, and they can really help you speed up your editing. You can save yourself a lot of time. They're usually not quite as aggressive as what I've done here, so you have a bit more creative freedom with your own edits on top of what the preset gives you. So check it out. I've linked them at the end of the video and they're in the description. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment, some feedback, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments as well. And until next time, please keep shooting, and I'll see you next week. Three things I'm recording on today can only go wrong.